Hey guys, and welcome back to Auction Not Included, Clay's Amazing Space Colony Simulator Extraordinaire. My name is Twitchi and we're playing on LZ Alpha as we have done for the past about 115 cycles now. Everything's going well and we've got a whole bunch of small little jobs to attend to before we can get on with trying to extract slime from this boy over here. Slime, of course, to fertilize our mushrooms because we took a weird world generation, one of the harder ones. I believe we're in Arboreal, but don't hold me to that because it's been a very long time since I chose which world it is we were playing on. But most important thing to note about this is no swamp biomes anywhere. This means that our access to slime and polluted oxygen is more than a little bit limited. We have all the chlorine you could ever want, but polluted oxygen and slime are definitely short. So the mushroom farm is going to be taking a little bit of a backseat as we try and figure out how to farm our puffs. But first, as I was saying, look at all this hydrogen that is totally messing up my guys' lives over here. I'm going to get this ventilation out. We're going to go for a gas pump. You guys might remember that we had one of these up here a little while ago and pulled it down because tidy. We're going to go ahead and put it back because we need this here to keep our whole base clear and fresh for everybody. Mainly because we've been knocking holes in roofs and stuff like that, which, you know, is not the best way of dealing with a nice, clean, tidy base, but it definitely is something that happens. So we just have to make do and see how we can fix it. And I think we're going to fix it just like that. Oh, we also get to unwrap this present together. Let's have a look and see what we have got here. Doctor in cooking. Man, we could have done with you a couple of episodes ago. We've got another cooking supply and building. These guys, I'm not actually that interested in. And also the poke shell. We've got, wow, we're going to hit a second reject. Oh, that is quite crazy. That is very crazy indeed. I mean, like, why would we just be wasting stuff like that? Because they don't give us anything better. Okay, so while they're building all of this, I'm going to come and look down here and see all of this chlorine kicking about here. Now, I have a little theory that if we just open these doors up here, hopefully the whole diffusion gradient here will help us out, because the chlorine I believe to be lighter than the carbon dioxide. I'm just going to go double check this now. Let's have a look and see if we have a density. Oh, we don't actually have a density written here. That's a little confusing because we do actually get density in the wiki. Yeah, there's not even a density in this little readout of stuff here. That's a little bit disappointing because I was going to compare this to the carbon dioxide and see if that indeed is the case, that it's more buoyant than carbon dioxide. But I suppose all we can do is wait. Well, one thing I am going to do is my age-old trick of a little bit of alert abuse. Let's see if other people come along and do some other jobs. This does bring to mind that we very much need to try and get some sort of operating specific duplicant so that we can get someone in to just... whose job is just to go around and do these little things that I need them to do. Okay, doors are open. Let's watch out for the diffusion gradient. Hopefully all these chlorines are just going to come out here and drift their way up into this mess, which hopefully we can then fix with a few other pumps at some point. But we'll see what happens. If all else fails, we'll open this one down here to pump out the gas. But I think we should be okay. Maybe this needs to fill up with more carbon dioxide before it will push out. But I kind of thought that's what this would do. This carbon dioxide coming in through here would like drop down and then start to fill up the area as more chlorine goes out. All right, maybe it's just going to take some time. Oh, everyone's coming to tidy up. That's why they keep coming on down here. That's no problem. But whilst the cipher's down here, I want to say something. These slicks, right? They eat gas. So, why do they have teeth? Why is the cipher having to clean his teeth? What's going on with that? That just seems like evolution gone mad. Also, can we, like, power this up like this? We can't. Okay, so I need to use, some conductive wire to get in here. But what we actually need is a transformer. Maybe we should have put a transformer box over here to power all the lighter material with. And then we could have just not had these joint plates here. But, you know, this is the situation we find ourselves in now. So I'm just going to leave this like this. Maybe a transformer for all the doors wouldn't go amiss. Okay, so this pump has got fired up. I really did want to get these control systems set up before this started pumping out, but I've got no real issue with what's going on here. It's just a little bit of a nice want, that is all. But down here, you can see that I'm starting to work on a new area, and the new area that I'm going to work on is indeed a puffed farm, as I was indicating earlier. Now, this is going to take a little bit of work to get going in the right and proper manner, but, you know, I'm not overly shy of a little bit of work. To anyone that knows me personally, that statement's hilarious. Okay, and as we can see, the hydrogen is being pumped out of here and down this way. Now, it would be nice to have something other to do with it than just dump it in these rooms here. But for the moment, that will do until we have something like a hydrogen generator, or we have the thermal anti-entropy device or something like that. Something that comes along that actually needs this hydrogen. And downtime has been cool, which means all work has finished, which will be interesting to see how this reacts overnight just as it is set up. You can see that we've actually started to slow down on the oxygen production because of the way this comes in here, but I suppose that's okay because eventually we'll actually end up with oxygen up here. That's what this little control device that I'm trying to build is going to be all about. I want to have a gas element sensor that when it when it detects oxygen, tells it to stop. That's what the knock gate's about. I feel like we could put this in a better order here. Maybe have the gas element sensor over this side, though it looks like it's constantly going to be pulling a vacuum there, which is quite cool, I want to say. Yeah, look at that. That is quite interesting. Okay, and overnight we have cleared out the majority of the hydrogen out here. You can see that we're actually picking up bits of oxygen as well, which I would be like, oh no, we're going to need to leave that oxygen out there. But we don't, because it's also now going back into the base. So yeah, no, I'm kind of cool with what's going down. I really wish we would get this built nice and quick though we don't have the materials for the wiring, so I'm coming over here. Forrest says he is going to get to it at some point. He had a little bit of life support maintenance to deal with first though. And you know what? I'm fine with people dealing with life support maintenance. All right, materials are being dropped off, but who's actually going to end up using it? My man Shrouticus. Wow, do you have an operating score? Is that something you can do? Let's go to the skills and have a look. Shrouticus, what are you doing down here? You can only grill at the moment, but I'm sure, yeah, you've got some operating. You're not averse to operating, shall we say, so you can definitely get a little bit of work on that, though of course the grilling needs to be top priority. Let's check your priorities quickly. Shrouticus cookie, yeah, no, we're all good. Okay, the chlorine's still kind of just hanging around here. Starting to get the impression that maybe chlorine and carbon dioxide have the same weight, maybe? But anyway, Shroudkus came along and did the wiring for it. Well, it did the resource generation for us, so we can now do the wiring. Hey, what's this Puffed about to do? Let's follow him up and see what we can do. Follow Cam? Yeah, hey man, how are you doing? Let's see when you get to the top, what are you going to lay? I should imagine it's going to be some oxalite. Yeah. That's because he's breathing oxygen. This is one of the wonderful things about the Puffed. Princes is they will eat polluted oxygen, chlorine or oxygen and produce slime, bleachstone or oxalite dependent on what they've been consuming. Okay, we're possibly in danger of once again running out of room here, so we're gonna go base gas reservoir. I'm gonna pop it like right next to I can't because of these over here. Not great. Okay, Mad Frank coming along and doing the business here. We've got our gas element sensor, and I'm gonna tell you that I want this set up to detect, where are we down here, oxygen, and then the knock gate comes through. So it's not detected oxygen, so it's not turned it off. That's kind of what I'm saying here. Just gone through and set the priority up on every other tile here because I want to try and get this hydrogen out of the base. And the best way I can do that is clear this tunnel free at the top here to enable a free flow of the hydrogen towards this little cleaning scrubbing unit over here. Maybe we want to fill this in as well. I'm just going to quickly do that. We're just going to like do this and this and see if anybody comes along and does that. I mean, it would be a lot easier if we do that as well. For the displacement, of course. Oh, here comes Miss Lion. She's like, oh, yeah, I see you've built this tile. Let me come along and dig some holes out here. And I'm like, yeah, that's your job. Well done. And once she's done up top, straight down here to carry on digging out into the little chlorine storage facility we have over here. Really want to get these done, though. Oh, the base must have, yeah, it's spitting out a little bit. Oh, I see what's happened here. This has finally gone and got built. This has taken literally, like, episodes to get turned on. I want this to just scrub out all of the natural gas that we've got here. Also, kind of need to take this output and put it down the end of here. I think that would be an ideal scenario, but we've just got to deal with it as we can for the moment. This was literally just a temporary setup to scrub it, and it just never got built. Well, I'm going to leave it for a little bit and see if it cleans up the air pretty well. I'm hoping that the chlorine and the oxygen that gets spat out over here are just, you know, fun little side effects. Oh, we're out of power. Out of power? How are we out of power? These are on, like, super high priority. Well, yeah, that's not super high priority, but they're on fairly high priority, and people aren't even coming down to restock them. What? How's the coal doing in here? Do we have any coal? 200 kilograms. I mean, that's some, not loads. And coal is being dropped off here, so that should be fine. Displacement. It's a hell of a drug. I was always under the impression that the carbon would build up on the right-hand side of the base, not the left. Are we spinning the other way? Has the Coriolis effect got the other direction on the go? Maybe we should watch some gases drift around and maybe try and determine that. But no, look, we've got this sort of diagonal gradient here. That's what I was expecting. Oh, wait, no, that is the wrong way. Okay, misaligned to sign that today is the day for clearing the passage at the top. Cycle 117 going well. What are other people doing? Let's cycle through the stress indicators here. Decipher going around. He's recovering breath and then he's going to do some ranching. It's the next job, but not the top priority. I'd like to see what it is you're going to do. Moving down with a whole group of people. Well, this is amazing. So we definitely need to make this more of a super highway down here. If we could get some sort of the tubes were good. Maybe we could do that down here. But as I was saying, the fire pole, also a great idea. So he's just going to go do a ranch. Okay, we know what's going on there. Mad Frank, he's got his mad building skills on the go. What are we going there? We're going to construct a tile. It's very high priority. I can only assume that is... Oh, I was going to say in base, but where's he going now? Okay, it kind of just stops here, look. Where are you going? Oh, so we're doing the recover breath. Okay, so that's a big issue here. The fact that we got this chlorine and carbon dioxide cap that's just stopping people enjoying this beautiful oxygen. All right, that was Mad Frank. Misaligned, what are we doing here? She appears to be, well, I was expecting her to be working over this side, but I suppose, yeah, she needs to recover some breath as well. So we've got that issue over here as well. All big problems. Biggest problem seems to be the one that we've got no power at the moment. Maybe someone's going to get around to dealing with that. But this is why we need an operator duplicant, so that they can just go around and do those things. I'm guessing the fact that I've put this up at super high priority is what's going wrong here. We've got the materials that we needed, so if I bump this back down to a 5, it shouldn't be as much of a problem anymore. All right, Mr. Line getting back to work, which I hope should be the digging out of this area over here, because of course we want to get this second gas reservoir down, because we're just about to fill up this one. Bit of a shame that it's obsidian here. It's taking her a lot longer to dig through than I would particularly like. Okay, let's go check and see what Forrest is doing. He is breathing, but he's storing eggshells and polluted water. Where is the polluted water going? We kind of want to put that somewhere else. He's going to say go to the bottle emptier, but it doesn't say where the actual polluted water is. Let's have a look down here, because I would kind of like... Wait, is there a liquids? There's a liquids. Polluted water? Where are you? Are you even, like, germy? You're not germy. The thing is, we can't guarantee that's... Is this all of it? Is that all of it? Okay, that's interesting. I didn't think that would be there. Like, that would be much better if we could just dump it up here. But I've got a feeling Forrest is going to get to the job before we actually get round to that. Let's see what Luna's doing. Luna should be, yeah, harvest and storage. So that's kind of okay. She's much more on the farming. Let's check her priorities right now. Is she really much more on the farming? Okay, I'm going to put Decipher on that more than Luna, because, of course, he's got the big skills for that. And now Luna's going around doing all the coal storage that I said we would. Okay, cool. I like this going through and making sure everybody's doing what we think they're doing. All right, Dr. Captain Subs, he's also storage. The thing with Dr. Captain Subs here is, of course, he doesn't have to do his job most of the time. Yeah, the majority of the time, everyone's fine. Where are you going? Oh, it's storing igneous rock. I thought you were storing coal. There's one thing about this to-do list here. This is not highlighted enough at the top here, I don't think. I think we need more big red flashy lights and stuff. You can see these 9s make me really feel like this is the high priority stuff. But like up here is really what's going on. And I wish they would portray that a little bit better. What's Shrouticus up to, my friend? How are you doing? Center of attention. Get yourself a little bit more stress. -5 stress for that. Beautiful. You're storing in the coal bin. Well, you would be if only you could breathe. Big issues. Okay, as seems to be the theme for today, we're going to go ahead and set up an automated filtration system to try and get rid of all this chlorine here. And eventually we should end up with just carbon dioxide. Fingers crossed. Oh, we heard that. And I've just noticed that a lot of people are dropping stuff down the bottom here. And because the ladders are not built, aren't able to go and grab them. So I'm going to put the priorities up on those. But let's press the H. Let's see if we've got an operator. Do we farming, ranching, farming, suit? Well, this guy's quite interesting. Or supplying. Oh, all right, Otto, or rather, should I say Cubic, welcome to the group. You don't have a mess table right now, so we're just going to kind of slip that in here. I wonder whether we can do an offset one, do that like that, and then have some sort of way up there. Let's try this. I'm going to do that. I'm going to go with the airflow tile, because, carpeting tile, the nicest tile. You know what, I'm going to go ahead and actually, do we not have enough reed fiber? Let's cancel that build. That would have been nice, but no. We're just going to go for a normal tile. I'm even going to go for sandstone. Wait, there's granite gives us a little bit more. And then do that. We'll have a ladder going up here. And this should be accessible, right? Let's do that and see what happens. And then, of course, we need another cot up here as well. Of course, Cubic is going to require... Let's give him that farmer trait and give him a farmer hat. You are our farmer, Cubic. Oh, no, not into the skills. I want the priority. Let's come down here. Cubic, hey, cooking. You're not allowed to cook. Okay, fair enough. Farming, pump that priority. Ooh, there we go. Okay, Cubic going for his weird initiation ceremony where he gets his brain scanned and given a little bit of a light-sensitive frontal cortex. I think that's what's going on anyway. But all in all, he gets a hat. And the fancy hats are what it's all about, right? Cubic only got the farming on the go here. Love it. We've got 3 of millwood harvest. We've got, like, 6 planter box of supplies. But mostly he just wants to relax. All right, fair enough. Okay, relax. They're all wild and don't seem to have a tame skill here. Has this not been used because he can't get his breath? I think that might be the case. Okay, are we going to go ahead and do something here? I think we are. I really could do... Oh, look, we can make an iron atmosphere suit. I don't want to make that forever, but I do want to make one. Okay, this might be the situation to start placing these down, but it might not. Of course, the main problem that we've got here is the fact that it's such a long way down. We can be making 2 suits, or rather, we've made one, and we could be making another one. And of course we have the oxygen supply right here, as long as we can get everything turning over again. So we need to kind of pump one of these into a higher priority for the moment. It's already at a fairly high priority, so I think we'll just wait and see if anybody's going to get round to doing the jobs they need to be doing. And of course 1.8 cycle on this geyser over here, at which point I'll need to turn this back on. Maybe actually before we even get round to that, I'm going to do the same as I've been doing elsewhere and hook up a massive thermosensor for everything, so when this gets to, oh, I don't know, 40 degrees or something, we'll tell it to turn the pump on. And then we enable that building. Oh, no filter selected. Of course, what we want to do here is chlorine, if I can find it. All right, if you fill chlorine, output a green signal. Okay, now this has got no power, but as soon as the power turns up, it should work out well. Is this, once again, Decipher not being able to do a full tame? He's carrying something. And he drops it. Okay, yeah, all right, maybe... Instead of people just wasting their time, we should put a checkpoint in. I'm a little bit worried that this chlorine gas pipe is going to be going right over the top of where we need to put the ExoSuit dock, but we'll find out. We'll find out. Well, that's lucky. It wants it underneath there. Okay, cool. Let's go and figure this out. We want a ventilation. We want to call a gas bridge down. That is going that way. Look, arrow on the bottom there. That's very important. There to there. And we might even want more. Of course, with no oxygen flowing, the first thing we're actually going to want to do is disable this building. But, you know, we'll work on it. We'll get it sorted. It'll be fine. Right. I need to put this up to a 9. Let's see what happens. Okay, Luna and Dr. Captain Subs on their way down here. We'll just have to wait and see where they're at. I'm fairly sure. No, they're both pretty close, so that's going to be cool. I'm wondering whether they're going to actually be able to hold their breath all the way down here. Dr. Captain Subs definitely needs to work on his cardio and running strength. But, you know, there we go. That's the situation we find ourselves in when you're a fresh-born duplicate. Okay, atmosphere suit done. Let's deliver that suit. Okay, that's cool. And then this I'm actually going to disable pretty much straight away. Ah, of course, power was also a thing. We'll make sure that that is hooked up. Okay, Shrek has just got a little bit of an athletics boost there, but this is hilarious. I keep watching him go down to the bottom of the ladder, pick up that egg, climb the way back up, and obviously can't make it all the way. This is why we need this pump up and running, but for some reason it's not going until the power is running. So for now, I'm going to just pump priority 9 on all of these. It's that problem again, guys. Okay, so we got the teeth. That's it. That's as far as we get. No taming for you. No, here goes Shroudicus for another round. But finally, this gas pump is on, and hopefully all the different gases are moving around, and we should hopefully be getting rid of all of this here, and hopefully the oxygen will just flow. Okay, the Cypher's coming back down for another go. Let's hope one of these slicks are super close and he can actually get a little bit of a taming thing done. There seems to be some sort of actual countdown timer on the go. He's not happy about the ventilation down here. Are they both not happy about the ventilation? I suppose that kind of makes sense, right? Seems to be really struggling to clear all the hydrogen out. I might even move that gas element sensor just down here so that it only happens when it builds up. All right, let's do that. I thought I'd be clever and put it at the top here, but it's not clever enough. It says he's glum, but it doesn't tell me why. His needs are not being met, but what? What is not being met? Maybe not hot enough? That could be a thing. Let's put in some not insulated tiles here. Something like this. Let's get an obsidian tile. Do that there and see what happens by the end of it. Okay, so we got oxygen flowing into the atmosphere suit, so that's pretty good. Look, yeah, we've even got a bit of a bar building up there. That's nice. I'll take another one if I can. What are we missing? Resources, materials, aluminium. How about, no, I don't even have any iron. Okay. Okay, Forrest got the atmosphere suit. Not exactly my first choice. I would have preferred Decipher, but let's see what happens here. Fabrication. Okay, we're going to store the algae, and then we're going to start working on the next exosuit. So that's pretty cool. That is exactly what I'm after. If we could do that, that'd be great. So up here, I've started adding a second floor to what was going to be our puff farm. This is, of course, so that I can start putting a bunch of polluted water on the floor, and we start making some polluted oxygen up here. Okay, Forrest has dropped off the atmosphere suit to go and do some rock crushing. I wonder who's going to be the first to come along and grab it. I am really hoping it's Decipher, but Decipher might actually be already down here, so I don't know if that's actually going to happen. Everybody's run through this way. And it's Luna. Luna wins the lottery. At some point, we're going to have to go as far as removing that door, I think. Luna, could you move down here, please? Thanks. Sorry. Oh, the gas geyser is pumping again, which means we really need to get this control unit sorted. Which also means the water's starting to flow again. Beautiful. We'll be interested to see what happens when this little water sieve here spits out again. We notice a lot of it goes up this way. Is it going to come down this way again? I'm hoping that it's a 50-50 split, but we can only find out. Content's empty. Why? What did you do with it? Okay, it seems to be, splitting it off equally in directions. I'm not sure exactly what it's doing, but it's doing a thing. Which of course means when the water gets up to this junction here, it's going to split in two separate pathways and hopefully lead to nice cooling but also nice warming. We need to get this back above 40 degrees on the water, look, because we're not killing many germs. So little that we've got like over 250,000 germs here. Wow, Forrest is quick at putting that exosuit on. And Miss Aline got the other suit. Okay, that's nice. She'll go around and do some good work. Really, again, would like Decipher down here to be able to get one though, so we could finish Tame. Is this gonna do it? No. God, Dr. Captain Subs in the exosuit is really slow, but I suppose that's okay. All right, Mad Frank came along and did this. If above 50, turn that on. There we go. That should be nice and easy and keep this all relatively chill. Let's actually say above 40 and then we'll know for definite. Okay, there it is. It's turning, it's doing. We've got this thermoregulator coming along and producing heat out here, which hopefully gets consumed by this and then doesn't pass on its heat to the generators. We'll find out. Okay, it turns out we're losing a lot of heat to our environment via the pipes, which might mean that we need to do things such as change these gas pipes' orientation to be the sideways ones, even though I don't think that will actually fit because of where this gas filter is. We'll have to see how this works out, but we are pumping out quite more chill oxygen over here. There's polluted oxygen here. Where does this come from? Oh, look. Ooh, must be from this down here, right? Yeah. Oh, I heard a noise. Let's go over here and have a look. I don't know exactly what we're looking for, but we will have a look. Doctor operating. Doctor operating, building. Who do we want here? We definitely want one of the operating. I'm probably going to go for the machinery plus three. This says Mimi. Mima. I'm going to go with Mimi. We all know a Mimi. Okay, let's go with that. New additions to the bedroom and the mess hall. So despite the fact that the natural gas geyser has actually sprung back into life, I'm a little bit worried about how our water supplies are doing. You can see that we are getting a little bit out of here, but it's only about 200 grams at a go if I have a look over this. Oh no, maybe about a kilogram, something like that, but that is still a very small amount. It comes up here, it gets processed, and it gets passed down over to this area, and you can see that we are starting to run out quite badly of water. Now, water is an essential ingredient in this game. I'm not sure if you guys are fully aware of its importance, but most things run from water, from the farms to the research, even so much as the carbon scrubber over here needs fresh, clean water to run. A little while ago, we got ourselves a desalinator. We also found that we had a saltwater geyser over here. I'm wondering whether we can put these two facts to great and simple use. We're going to need to pull some power down down this way. That's not going to be a problem. And downtime has struck just as Cubic was passing by. But you can see I've got a little setup here. We've got a liquid pump down below. We've got the desalinator. We've got some pipes joining it all up and, of course, wires as well. I'm going to turn these tiles into mesh tiles when the time is right and make a little pool over this side to try and figure out what we need to do with the salt water. Do we need to pass it through some ice and make ourselves a much cooler area? I don't know. I'm not sure what temperature this is going to come out of here. If we have a small mouse over this, we might be able to get some sort of temperature out of it. This is coming out at 100 degrees. That's pretty hot. And least we forget, all this is so that we can end up with some slime for the dust cap over here. The water is going to drop into there. We'll pump that out down to a carbon skimmer down below, where we will pump some of the polluted water into pincher peppers and the rest of it up here to smear out and make polluted oxygen for our puffs that we're going to get in there. It sounds like a good plan. I hope it's going to work out, especially with the end of the episode closing in so fast. How are we getting overheat damage? How is this happening? Okay, we've got a lot of heat coming from this guy right here. I might disable this one and see whether the other guys can deal with it, because there's a lot much nicer cooling system going on over here. So if we put this at the highest priority, and I would also like to put these in at some pretty high priorities, and whilst we're going around doing that, I think these are also super, super important. So hopefully everyone's working over this side. Now, the real question, of course, is can people hold their breath for long enough to come along and do all the work that needs doing over here? I certainly hope so. Are they both surviving off this tiny little blob of oxygen here? Wow. Oh, here they go again. Oh no, they're bypassing this one this time. They're going up here. I mean, that's kind of okay, I suppose. I wonder if we've got, nice gases being thrown out of this yet. Looks like a few of them. Too many people running around with atmosphere suits on inside the base, so I've asked people to lock the airlock over here to stop that happening. And also, Shroudcus, my man, you really need to just kind of move over here. This is interesting. There's a bunch of polluted something or other down here. Polluted dirt, and it's emitted a load of polluted oxygen. But Mr. Lion is using it to survive down here. So props for the survival skills, eh? Oh, end of the cycle. We've got a fair bit of it actually sorted out. We'll see if we can't put in the last bit of piping. I think we're going to take this out of here. It's going to come up and along this way and then all the way over to here. Okay, I think we've got the majority of the things in place here. Let's just take these out and, of course, then start to dig through here like this. The reason I don't take these two out is because I don't want people going through the airlock quite yet. There does appear to be some water there, and I don't want it all flowing out. Okay, that's the last pipe in place, and I think Mr. Lion is now going to come down here and start playing around with these rocks. Mad Frank, of course, came through and took them out earlier. This should be nice and simple. We've got a few bits of obsidian to take out, but that is no big problem. Oh, she's going to reach through and take that out as well. Okay, that's fine. Wouldn't you believe it? It's dormant. It's actually dormant. How is this? When does it start again? We don't know. So I've called in the researcher forest, and we'll find out. Oh, wow. So these slicksters have become tamed, and as you can see, they are eating at a phenomenal rate. They've eaten up all the carbon dioxide down here. I'm going to start opening doors to allow them to eat to the rest. What is all this crack stuff here? Oh, that's an interesting overlay. Why have we got that? Oh, I don't know. But once we've got all that sorted, it's going to be amazing. Maybe we could get all this down there somehow. Maybe a bit of a ventilation pipe. Yeah, that'd be great. All right, we have our first drops of water going into the carbon scrubber down here, which is also powered. Unfortunately, it's got a whole, pipes blocks it. Oh, has it not? Is this going up here? Ah, it can get up to this bridge, which will then say that it is blocked. Yeah, look at that. Okay, beautiful. These guys are then going to come along building these pipes so that we can finally have some outputs, again, for the pinch of peppers and for the slime factory up here. Big problems with the overheats down here. I'm going to go look in the power. I'm going to look in my natural gas generator. I'm going to see all the things that I can make out of. Both have an overheat temperature at 75. Neither are good enough for me. So the puff princes eat everything, right? So if I go for the food and come down to the airborne critter bait, I thought I would have some problems because I don't have any slime. But if they also eat bleach stone, let's try luring him in here like this. Can we leave the door open? I would like that at the highest priority possible, please. Also, you can see that the water is starting to spread out down here. That's nice. That's exactly what we wanted, and it's starting to outgas a bit of polluted oxygen. Let's have a look. Where is it? There it is. That's what we're after. That is exactly what we're after. Ooh, downtime. They're just going up and over the top when I lock this door. We know how to fix this. We put down another door here and we lock that as well. Okay, so this critter bait has gone down, which means I probably want to put this on auto now. We need to see if he's going to come on down here. I think he should do. I'm not sure if he needs a line of sight or what. We'll hang around and I'll tell you what he needs, whether he's just going to start pathing over that way. I'm not sure if there's like a range or anything like that. He seems to be moving slowly towards it, slowly but surely. Oh, no, off he goes. Ooh. Okay, the next activity for this is going to be in 1.3 cycles. This path prince doesn't appear to want to do anything that I would like him to. Even though I've got the bait down there, maybe we need to have a slime one. If we do click on him, you can see that there is information down here saying that he will only eat slime, and then updated information underneath that. So maybe this is actually a little bit of a bug from older versions where he won't go after all the food that he wants. But I'm afraid with that, I'm going to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you guys next time. We're going to try and take care of the water issue. As we say, it's down there. Get that puffed farm, turn it over properly, and reap the benefits of this lovely, beautiful carbon dioxide scrubbing system that we have down below. But I will see you then when we're going to do that. Bye!